One thing I always like to do, and I might get some hate comments for it, but I don't really care, is I'll actually put anti-seize on the threads on the crankshaft pulley bolt. I also talked to another guy that says he always replaces the crankshaft pulley bolts, but I never have. The crankshaft pulley is pretty easy to come off. Just wiggle it. Not like Toyota, where sometimes you have to have a puller to get these things off. There you go. You are free and clear. Oh, wow. Okay, there should be a little plate, a ring, that keeps the, that goes between the crankshaft pulley and the timing belt, but it's not there, it's gone. So right here, there should be a little plate, but it's not there. Also, you have this keyway right here too. That lines up with the crankshaft. This is actually a crankshaft. This is the end of the crankshaft right here. And that keyway needs to be in there. So do not install your timing belt without that keyway. Wow. Whoever did this, did a... It's not a good sign. Kind of a hack job, whoever was in here. So, well, at least I know the timing belt has been changed, because if it was from factory, if it was from Honda, it would have that little piece. Let me see if I have an extra one. I'll show you what I'm talking about. Okay, so this is the piece I'm talking about. This is like a beveled washer. This should have been on the crankshaft pulley bolt between, or between, this should have been between the crankshaft and the belt. So you can see right here, oh, sorry, it's kind of hard to see. Once you get in there, you'll see that it's beveled. It's actually beveled out this way. It's that way, okay? And so the part that's beveled, that's coming out, it should be towards the crankshaft pulley. So if I was in there like this, right? Hopefully you guys can see that. It would sit like this. Once I can line it up. It would sit in there just like that. Okay? So make sure you have that in place. And also make sure you have that keyway in place as well. Now I took this off because I wanted to... I took this off because I wanted to get the tensioner out of the way. So I have the 14 millimeter bolt out on top or in the middle, and then I'll come from the bottom here and take out, it's either 10 millimeter or 12 millimeter. I think it's a 12 millimeter.